Will you please join me on the stage as I call your name? Members receiving their award today are Ashley Olson and Katie Taylor.
Where's your certificate?
Oh, yeah.
They're all the problem. Oh, no.
The other members have received their award at a county achievement night and are whom we would like to recognize here. Elizabeth Paxson, Ashley Lowinger, Harrison Hargle-Rode, Juliana Payne, Bailey Morris, Janet Champlin, and Angela Richards. A Diamond Clover is achieved by meeting 9 mandatory requirements, including having a winner or medalist record book at state competition, earning a gold medal at sectional or state presentation day, completing at least 100 hours of community service, attendance at SOC or a sectional conference. Everyone here today can check off that one. In addition to the mandatory requirements, each member must complete 4 additional requirements from a list of 8 options. There are such things as being a state ambassador, serving as a judge at county sectional or state field day, serve as a team leader for 3 years. The member standing before you have achieved and in most cases exceeded the requirements of the Diamond Clover Award. Congratulations, you are the best of the best. Congratulations to all of the award recipients.
It takes a whole lot of hard work and behind the scenes to make a conference happen. And we'd like to thank everyone who had a large part in this conference. Thank you to the support group team. Support group team, please stand. Thank you to the program assistants. Program assistants, please stand. And thank you to all the chaperones. Chaperones, please stand.
SLC Planning Committee team. They have been hard at work. They have been hard at work year round to make this conference a success. Thank you to the Make It Happen Committee for getting together all the details and making the State Ambassador team's dream a reality. So please do. Educational components of the conference and making sure that we all make this conference better leaders. Please stand. Lastly, thank you to the Make It Fun Committee for making every second of this weekend so enjoyable. Please stand.
And of course, thank you to the Make It Safe team for helping us with our medical needs and watching over us here at Pomble. Please give all the 2016 State Leadership Conference staff a round of applause. We've had a great year as a team of state ambassadors, and it is now time for us to graduate on a new event. I would like to welcome Brianne Sanchez up to the stage.
Woo!
close to sum up an unforgettable year spent with lifelong friends I've made in just a few minutes. There's no way to describe all of the memories we've made along the way, but allow me to share a few. The night of our first official meeting, our team bonded over jacuzzi time and late night TV shows. And at the meeting the next day, that's when I realized how grateful I am to be a member of this team. We work extremely well together because we focus on each other's strengths. And that same night, we went out to dinner, and I cannot remember laughing that much in a long time. Flash forward to our other meeting dates, and they become a blur. But too many times are hard to forget. Like watching the internship in Laurel and Katie's room late at night while the rest of the guys tried getting us to come out and swim with them. Or when we got free fast passes by accident at Disneyland and we cut everyone just because we could. And when Steve would wear that dumb mama mask and randomly knock on our hotel door. I can't forget hearing each incident that someone would miss their train too. Not just once, not even twice. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I think it was like 3 or 4 times. And after St. Phil Day, we ate at Chevy's and stuffed ourselves with Mexican food and sang along to the radio. We even got matching sombreros. Best of all, just recently at Cal Focus, Jackie and I were sent back to the Capitol to finish the voting ballot, but my Maps app sent us back to the wrong hotel, so we took a 20-minute detour. I feel like you can almost make a reality TV show about the student ambassador's life, and people will be entertained for hours. All of these memories wouldn't be possible without some of my favorite people. So all of our guys on the team, I couldn't have asked for anyone better. Lyle, I hope you realize that you're a genius in disguise, and I wish you the best of luck in the future. And don't forget that the Golden Eagle party was always better. Brennan, I've never met anyone who knows so much about the outdoors and self-defense as you. It was nice having someone my age on the team, and thank you for not letting me get lost on the way back to the Pagoda Building at Capitol. Trent, I am positive that I've never met anyone as hardworking and determined as you. Crazy. I know you'll be really successful in the future. He already is. And since you always want to meet famous people, I hope you'll let me know when you meet Taylor Swift. And Steven, where do you even start? Thank you for loving Panda Express as much as me and for slowing us down at the airport every time we had to go through security. In all honesty, you have the best attitude towards everything in life, and I hope that in the future you never run out of fish to catch. And to all of the girls on the team, thanks for being the sisters I never had. Mary's not here, but I'm still going to read this. Mary, you seem to always be wearing a smile, and your ideas are always so insightful. I've always wanted to be a person who loves math, and I can now say I have, so thank you. I wish you the best of luck in the future, but at the same time, I know you'll be great. Laurel, you're such a sweetheart, and you're incredibly smart. You brought so much to the team, especially new Pandora rap stations. I know you'll be as amazing as always at Berkeley. And Katie, or shall I say the bumblebee of our team, you have such a free spirit, and you don't see that too often. I respect that about you and your opinions on everything more than everyone. Ashley, thanks for being one of the best roommates ever, and for staying up to watch our favorite cooking show all night. You have so much talent for so many things, and you constantly amaze me. I know you and Katie both will have a great time friends. And of course, Jackie. From day one, same ambassador interview, you have such a good friend to me. You have such a kind heart, so the love you give to all of us has always been contagious. Thank you for sharing a bed with me every time so that I wouldn't actually have to pull out. And above all, thanks for always showing me so much love. I can't wait to hear about Washington State and all of the great things that you and Trent will be doing on the new team. Jenna, you've been a lifesaver for us all, and especially me. Thanks for taking care of all of my travel arrangements, and for always being super flexible and understanding. You've taught me what a real new adult partnership should embody, and I will take this with me for the rest of my life. You're the best mentor and leader that anyone could have asked for, and I want to say thank you from the bottom of my heart. To the incoming team, treasure the time that you spend together because time flies when you're having fun. And I know it did for me this past year. Thank you.
My fourth grade self walked into my first 4-H meeting with wide-eyed apprehension and a strange feeling that this foreign place would soon become my second home. I was eager to explore the opportunities available to me, signing up for 8 projects my first year. I discovered I loved STEM, sewing, raising miniature breeding sheep as therapy animals, and public speaking. I found my 4-H friends and peers that shared similar interests. Participating in mutual relationships was and still is important to my development as a benevolent, determined individual. I am surrounded by 4-Hers who supplement my passion with their own. This creates an environment of sharing and collaboration that feels both safe and ambitious. My 4-H community is dynamic. By 2014, I began searching for leadership opportunities with a larger perspective and greater responsibilities. By branching out, I found a new community at the state level as a member of the California 4-H State Ambassador Team. My support system is derived from my state 4-H community. Sorry. Diverse in age, perspective, and passions, my 4-H friends encourage me to be an active participator and an innovator. Working with my ambassador team creates a unique subset of my community that is both personal yet diverse. I connect with my 9 best friends from across California through a love of 4-H, through a love of the 4-H program and community service, despite our contrasting backgrounds. My love for 4-H was reinforced when I met 4-Hers from across the state and nation while presenting at the Healthy Living Summit in Washington, D.C. I met youth from Illinois, North Carolina, Tennessee, Georgia, and beyond, and was able to connect with people that came from completely different backgrounds than me through a mutual love of 4-H. My 4-H community has pushed me to challenge myself and pursue my passions while working collaboratively in pursuit of common goals. I am so thankful for the opportunities that 4-H has provided me with and owe my phenomenal 4-H experiences to all of the advisors and friends that have helped me along the way. I encourage you all to expand your 4-H horizons, as you've already done by attending this conference, and make the most of everything 4-H has to offer. And now I'd like to welcome Stephen.
My name is Stephen Johnson, and I'm a 4-Her. Throughout my years, I've had many different titles. in the program: County All-Star, Club President, State Ambassador, and other things. But above all those titles, I am still a 4-Her. I started 4-H at the young age of 5, running around with my little blue-eyed white Polish rabbits, and I was hooked. 4 years passed, and I discovered my spark, which was public speaking. This project would turn out to be not only my absolute favorite project, but also a lifelong skill that I would use countless times. Although I had an undying love for public speaking, I was still stuck in my shell, and I needed to be cracked out of it. It wasn't until TIC 2012 that this happened to me. I was a shy 12-year-old with long hair, going to my first ever 4-H conference, and after 3 days, I was a changed person. I went out and talked to people, led people, learned from others, and applied what those people taught me, and used it so many different situations, it was amazing. Shy was no longer my vocabulary. And if it wasn't for that one conference, I'm pretty sure I wouldn't be standing up here today. I guess what I'm trying to say is, don't be afraid to step out of your comfort zone. I lost where I'm going. Don't be afraid to step out of your comfort zone. I know it can be hard, but trust me, it will pay off in the end. And even well past your 4-H career, it'll still be paying off. It will be more than worth it. I'd like to thank my state ambassador team for the amazing year, all the fun memories, all the great memories. You know, it was just, you guys are amazing. I love all of you. I'd like to thank the rest, Jenna and Gemma, and everyone else on our team as well. I'd like to thank, I'm thanking everybody right now. I'd also like to thank, I'm sorry. I'd also like to thank Imperial County 4-H for all the great years and the support, and my parents for dealing with me. And most importantly, I want to thank you, California 4-H, for being here so I could talk to you. Thank you. And stay happy, stay great, and stay green.
I'm Ashley, and I'm proud to say I was part of the state ambassador team. This term has been an experience of a lifetime, and I'm so grateful to have had the opportunity to take the journey with these 9 incredible individuals. When we first started to get to know each other, little did we know that our bond would grow as strong as it is today. Whether this may have been stealing food from each other without asking, rocking out to Fetty Wap in the hotel room, and Jenna constantly reminding us, no gang signs and pictures. But in all seriousness, working together with this amazing group led us to finish projects. And as we stand here today, we are able to look back and say, wow, I can't believe we just did that. Events such as State Field Day, Cal Focus, earning $1,000 for California 4-H because of our work with TxDOT Act, and soon to say SLC. Memories were created through this past 14 months, and the amount of selfies, group pictures, and Snapchat pictures and videos that we have taken definitely reflected this. When I first started 4-H, I made a goal for myself that I would earn the state ambassador rank, just as my mom did back in 1978. Actually, watching. Hi, Mom. Looking back now, I am so thankful that I never stopped pushing past this dream of mine. I am so grateful for what 4-H has done for me, the opportunities and lessons that have come along with it, the friendships that have developed over this past 9 years, and I hope that in this next chapter of my life, I will continue to make the best better. Thank you, Jenna, and the entire California 4-H staff. To each one of the members of the team, I am honored to have been a member of and 4-H program as a whole for me, allowing me and the youth today to be able to make a difference in the world. And now I'd like to welcome Katie Taylor to the stage.
All right. Hey, everyone. First of all, I'd like to thank everyone on my team for being so amazing, kind, and unselfish. We have gotten along so well and created really special friendships. I'm looking at Laurel. And everyone else. Don't worry. They know. I've been so blessed to have 10 new friends and make memories while traveling to Washington, D.C., or sharing my love of French music and Fetty Wap. Jenna, Gemma, Ryan, and Grace always laughed with me when I spoke my mind about any topic that needed to be discussed or when I made a joke. I've learned through my 4-H journey to be yourself and encourage other people's dreams. 4-H wasn't always the cool thing to some of my school friends, but it made me happy. I had friends who pushed me in 4-H to continue even when it was hard or took up all of my spare time. I managed to finish high school as a state ambassador, AP student, varsity tennis player, student government member, perform 750 plus hours of community service in 4 years. Thank you. And have an above 4.0 GPA. I have a great family who always supported my 4-H dreams. I'd like to thank God, my parents, hey Mom, I know you're watching, my twin sister Jackie, and my oldest sister Beth, my boyfriend Nick,
the Marshall family, Grandpa Dwight, and 4-H leaders, Georgine Diener and Liz Villalobos of Fresno County, for helping me on this journey. I'd like to end by encouraging everyone in this room to follow their dreams. I've been able to serve as a club officer multiple times, team leader, become a camp counselor, become a Fresno County All-Star, now Diamond Clover, and state ambassador. After accomplishing one goal, I had to chase another, then another. I knew I wouldn't be satisfied until I completed all of the goals on my 4-H list. If you have a goal, check it off your list. Goals may change, but don't give up on them. Thank you, California 4-H. I'd like to welcome Trent to the stage.
I like lost it half like a sentence into Brianne, so bear with me. Okay. At my very first SLC in Davis 2013, I sat in a closing assembly just like this one. The state ambassadors were doing their closing speeches just like I am now. And I remember my cousin Emily leaning and whispering, "That's gonna be us on that stage one day." And I was like, "No. You will never drag me up there." Where I was in that moment as a person and where I am now on the stage is what 4-H means to me. A few years ago, I couldn't talk to other people easily or speak to crowds. I did not have the confidence that I needed in myself to be successful. I was kind of the weird kid from Monterey County that was obsessed with llamas.
Yeah, llamas!
And I dressed like a tornado in a rainforest cafe. In the middle of my high school years, I went through a really tough and dark period of my life that I thought I would never get out of. A year after Davis, I came back to SLC in Santa Cruz, and for me that year was completely different. I was surrounded by my friends from my county, and I had not one, but two cousins with me, which is double the fun. And double the crazy. It was at this conference that my 4-H journey really began to me. For whatever reason, I thought Cole was like Superman. Probably because I had never met someone else that would refuse to wear anything else but cargo shorts. Answer this really concerned. I think seeing that year's state ambassadors on stage made me realize that I was capable of anything that I set my mind to. And it gave me a reason to be confident in myself as a leader. That was really a big turning point in my life. The very day after that SLC was over, I decided I was going to throw myself headfirst into 4-H. As a disclaimer, before 2 years ago, I really wasn't involved with 4-H all that much. I had thought there really wasn't anything 4-H had to offer to a total goofball like me. And in fact, I had considered quitting 4-H the year before. But after SLC Santa Cruz, I felt like I had a mission and new motivation to do great things at the county level. I put my all into being an all-star, going to leadership conferences, and most importantly, meeting all the Monterey County 4-Hers that became my family and support me to this day. Where's Monterey County at? Come on. My senior year of high school, I devoted myself to being as engaged in 4-H as I could be. I realize now I've become a much more confident public speaker, grew confidence in myself, but most importantly, that dark spot in my life grew much brighter. My 4-H family and All-Star team were a strong support system, and I owe this program the world. I decided to become a state ambassador to inspire confidence in other members and help them help themselves. I wanted to help members that might have been seen as unconventional leaders, just like I am, to reach great things. But what the state ambassador experience has given me is far greater than anything that I could give back to it. From this last year alone, I've learned so much about myself. But in all of truth, I've learned the most from the other amazing members of this team. This team has been like a family to me since day one, from over a year. I don't know what I would have done without all the laughs, smiles, train rides, adventures, and support that the team has given me. From the very first day at interviews, I remember Jackie and Brianne welcoming me, Ashley with the bubbles. I remember Steven just being Steven, and Brennan and Katie and Laurel and Lyle and Marin have been nothing but family to me since day one. I don't know what I would have done without them, and I'm sad that this year has come to an end. But like a family, I know we'll never stop being the 2015-2016 State Ambassador team. Ryan and Grace, thank you so much for all the support that you've given the team over the past year. Thank you to the planning team for such an SLC, such a successful SLC. It was an SLC. And for being awesome. Jenna, thank you so much for an amazing year. and for being the student ambassador team member. Nothing could have been possible without you, and I'm so thankful for everything you've done with this team. To everyone in the audience, all the 4-H'ers, I want to thank you guys for being awesome young people that have taught me so much over the last year. I hope all of you find what you're passionate about through this organization. If there's anything that all of my 4-H experiences have taught me, it's that there is no limits to what I can accomplish, or no limits to the places that I can go. But most importantly, over the past few years, 4-H and SLC have become like a family. Just like my real family, we're really loud, and there are too many of us to count. The person on the left and on the right of you might have your back down the road, and you might have theirs. I encourage all of you in the audience to support one another, just like I promised to support all of you guys through any endeavors. Thank you. I would like to welcome Jackie Petter up to the stage.
I have opportunity to present workshops around state, help back our focus, and also see, do things related to our social media health platform. Our social emotional health platform. I ran a booth at Ag Day, a booth at Geophysics Convention, attended Alba 4-H Club Week, that was a life-changing conference, and presented at the National 4-H Healthy Living Summit in Maryland. These experiences has enabled me to meet some of the amazing people from all over the world and make new friends close as California to as far as Canada and Finland. I'll still keep in touch with many of these friends, including the ones from Finland, which Snapchat has helped a lot. As a 4-H state ambassador, I have learned many life skills, and I have gained a lot of experience, like taking public transportation, especially trains to Davis. Some things I've learned: never, ever just pack shoes and a blow-up donut in your carry-on, because you never know when the airport's going to lose your luggage and you want to change your clothes for the host of the conference. I learned what to do if I miss a train, and what to do when I'm on the other side of the country when a plane gets canceled because of snow. Besides traveling, I've learned so much about this great state of California, including where the different counties are and all the cool opportunities youth have in the state. It's crazy to think this year has passed. I miss you guys. The crazy socks and the fanny bags and all the masks. With our different backgrounds and personalities, we came together from all over the state. Some of us from cities, in other words, some of us from farms. We work together to become a family. Oh, sorry, but always there for each other. We had some great memories together. Some of my favorite memories include doing facials, catching huge flies during interviews, hanging out at the pool after long meetings, watching movies in the hotel, seeing how many pancakes we can eat. I think Trent, he was able to eat over 10 pancakes. Kneeling down the halls of the state hall office in a car in Heatleys, playing in the snow while in DC, painting each other's names on each other's faces during state field day, and listening to Lyle's raps. I hope to stay in touch with my state ambassador family for many years to come. I just want to thank everyone who has supported me through
the best. Not a pee. But supporting me through these years of 4-H. I've gone as a person through the 4-H program. When I joined 7 years ago, I was shy, quiet, and hated to talk to people. Because of speech and language challenges, it made it difficult for me to speak with others that I didn't know. I joined 4-H because I just went to raise livestock and own some goats. And now I can see 4-H has done the impact to my life way more than just letting me raise livestock. The program has helped me find my voice, gain confidence as a public speaker and a leader, and to achieve many goals like becoming a state ambassador. Sorry. I look like an emotional black guy, but I feel really grateful for the experiences and growth that I have in 4-H. I'm really excited to be part of the next year's team as state ambassadors, too, which I'm, great in some different way. Now, please enjoy a recap of our year as state ambassador.
Beside you, and if you will forget how much you really mean to me. Every day I will remind you. Oh, find out what we're made of. When we are called to help our friends in need, you can count on me. 1, 2, 3, I'll be there. And I know when I need it, I can count. I don't wanna see the wires in the circus anymore. I wanna dream and make believe that you can fly. I don't need to be reminded what it takes to kill the fun. I got a head for a sharp knife. Yeah, it's easy to get colder, it's easy to forget. So meet me where the lights dim. We can wake up every morning, we can set ourselves on fire, we can do it all again. The words don't speak for us, they lack confidence. Yeah, we're only hearts and bones and blood. Oh, we're giants, giants. Till the darkness goes away, till the television finally tells the truth. You know, everybody's scared of things, they don't understand that all of the living they don't do. Yeah, it's easy to get colder, it's easy to forget. So meet me where the light's down. We can wake up every morning, we can set ourselves on fire. Don't feel like going home, but all my cash is gone, and I got nothing to do tonight. I'm passed out on the floor, up in the hotel bar, but it don't matter cause I'm feeling fine. I'm thinking life's too short and it's passing by. So if I'm gonna go it all, go big or go.
Join me in welcoming Jenna Colbert to the stage.
While she's up here, we have another thing for our mama cotto. Our 2015-2016 California State. As we come to the close of this part of our journey together, we will think about the great times we had and the adventures we've experienced as a team. We have learned many things together and from each other, the process of forming a team and moving through the stages to performing, communication skills, facilitation skills, the art of saying no, and accepting no,
We've had many successes as a team, building high-quality workshops, working in youth adult partnerships, selecting a service platform, and deciding how to get the message out to the 4-H community. Who could forget the road trips, the train rides, and adventures? Yes, airports in Washington, D.C. do really shut down when it snows, Katie. Do not wake up passengers, so watch for your stop tread. And hearing your advisor with a llama mask is not always the best idea for spending the morning. We have a theme, it's a llama theme. The 10 of you have shared 14 months with us, your 4-H family, and each other. For this, we thank you for your contribution. I'm going to share a little poem with you titled The Leader. Patient and steady with all he must bear, ready to meet every challenge with care. Easy in manner yet solid as steel. Strength in his faith refreshingly real. Isn't afraid to propose what is bold, doesn't conform to the unusual mold. Eyes that have foresight for hindsight won't do, never backs down when he sees what is true. Tells it all straight and means it all too, going forward and knowing he's right, and when doubted for what, for why, he would fight. Over and over, he makes his case clear, reaching to touch the ones who won't hear. Growing in strength, he would not be unnerved, ever assuring he'll stand by his word. Wanting the world to join his firm stand, bracing for war, but praying for peace, using his power so evil will cease. So much a leader and worthy of trust, here stands a man who will do what he must. Do not think of this day as an end, the beginning of a bright future. You may be moving forward in your lives, but you'll always have us, your 4-H family. I would now like to introduce our conference assistant directors, Grace Tobias and Ryan Cleveland. And now we would like to welcome to the stage our 2016-2017 state ambassadors, Debbie Kelly, Kaylee Cummings, Jordan Miner, Kara Gady, Riley Arbuckle, and Brett Wilkins. State ambassadors could not be present with us today. Gabriella Gerben, Albert Lizarraga, Olivia Snodgrass, and Aubrey Rose Stacy. We would also like to introduce the 2016-2017 second year state ambassadors, Jackie Penner and Trent Baldwin. The 2015-2016 California 4-H State Ambassador Team will present our new team with their pins.
As many of you know, the State Ambassador is the highest working honor a youth member can achieve in the California 4-H Youth Development Program. With the award comes the development of a statewide platform. This year, the State Ambassadors chose social and emotional health. With the award comes the responsibility of representing the State 4-H program at the highest levels of government, business, and academia.
The most important responsibility is to be a role model for over 30,000 members and 16,000 volunteer leaders and over 100 years of tradition that make up the California 4-H Youth Development Program.
This reward is not a medal. It is not a trophy. It is not made of gold or have any precious gems or jewels. The State Ambassador pin is a triangle, the strongest geometric shape known to man.
The outer border is trimmed in blue with a green 4-H clover at its heart on a field of gold. The blue and gold symbolize our association with the University of California, one of the nation's top academic institutions for research and education. The 4-H clover, a symbol that even our youngest members learn,
represent hand, heart, head, and health.
Thank you to the incoming state ambassadors. As SLC 2016 comes to a close, the technology leadership team has an afterglow presentation for us to remind us of all the fun times we have had together. But first, we also have a winner for our Instagram challenge. All right, and now the after.
Lightning strikes every time you
wow.
Woo!
Attending State Leadership, attending Leadership University over the last few days. I hope you enjoyed the State Leadership Conference experience. After the assembly, we'd like all adults, chaperones, PAs, and adult staff that have been a part of our time here at SLC 2016. Safe travels, everybody.
Just like that.